Thank you very much. And Mr. Koskinen, and I share Chairman Hatch's concern about bringing our bipartisan inquiry to a halt. And to get that done, to complete it in a thoughtful and a bipartisan way, we're going to need these documents. And as the chairman noted, we thought we were going to get some, and we're going to need them, and need them quickly. Whenever I talk with Oregonians in meetings or town halls, the conversation nearly always comes down to the same core issue, the struggling middle class. Years after economists first said that the recession officially ended, too many middle class Americans feel like they're standing on quicksand because the recovery has yet to reach them. So the challenge facing policymakers is putting America's middle class on solid economic ground, growing their paychecks, and ensuring that our recovery reaches everyone across America. That challenge is going to be top of mind at each of the three hearings, colleagues, that we hold this week. Tomorrow and Thursday, the committee will talk with HHS Secretary Burwell and Treasury Secretary Liu about the administration's plan to save Americans money on health care, create jobs, increase wages, and invest in the middle class. Today, the committee has an opportunity to discuss the status of America's accounting department, the Internal Revenue Service, with the Commissioner John Koskinen. With W-2 forms in the mail and the tax season beginning, our country's annual headache is now setting in. And I want to emphasize that today taxpayers reside in two separate worlds. In one world, a middle-class office employee pays taxes directly out of her wages, and she is subjected every spring to the painstaking process of filing returns. Colleagues, for that office worker, there are no complicated tax avoidance strategies at her disposal. She doesn't have any shelters. She doesn't have any vehicles for her to hide her income. Meanwhile, in the other tax world, teams of accountants go out to pry open loopholes that are hidden in the tax code, and the line between right and wrong is murky at best. The inherent unfairness of America's tax system is a blow that falls hardest on the middle class, and it takes a number of forms. The most obvious is that every year families spend more time and money filling out their taxes. People are worried about compiling all their records, completing all the forms, and then filing them correctly. Unfortunately, the tax code itself hadn't gotten any simpler, and the lack of resources at the IRS has slowed service in a number of instances to a crawl. Nina Olson, who is the independent IRS taxpayer advocate, calls, and I quote here, that this is the most serious problem facing taxpayers. When Americans call into IRS helplines, they often sit in long queues listening to hold music. Protections against identity theft are delayed. Taxpayers who worry they might be victims of scams can't end up getting the timely assistance that they need. Families that depend on a refund to help cover the mortgage or tuition get left waiting. Now, there's a second issue to consider today. According to the Internal Revenue Service, nearly $400 billion in taxes go unpaid each year. That's the tax gap. One of its biggest causes is the dishonesty of tax cheats and scammers who avoid paying what they owe. And it's important to reflect on who gets the short shrift as a result. It's the middle-class wage earner, once again, whose taxes come straight out of their paycheck. Honest taxpayers have to make up the difference when the scofflaws dodge their responsibilities, and that's wrong. But until Congress simplifies and restores fairness to the broken tax code, multinationals and those with high-priced accountants can continue to find loopholes. There is no question that the IRS can make better use of the resources it has. That is true for every federal agency, every private business, and the Congress itself. And it has been acknowledged by Commissioner Koskinen and his predecessor. Meanwhile, policymakers can't lose sight of the biggest challenge today, which is putting our middle class on solid economic ground. There are going to be many more opportunities for this committee to work on a bipartisan basis with the commissioner and the IRS to make the system work better for middle class families, including through comprehensive tax reform. The ultimate goal ought to be fairness. And as I wrap up, I want to come back to the fact that taxpayers shouldn't be divided into two worlds. And one of those today carries a much heavier burden than the other. So, Commissioner, we look forward to working with you and our colleagues to make that a reality, and I thank you, Mr. Chairman.